Max is back, but he's far from sorted. Casualties in 45 minutes. Big games and big money first on BBC One. Lulu's on Red Alert.
With the National Lottery, and time to make room on the sofa for Lulu.
Your lights are on, but you're at home. Your mind is not your own. Your heart sweats, your body shakes. It's what it takes. You can't sleep, no, can't eat. There's no doubt you're in deep. Your throat is tight, you can't breathe. Another kiss is all you need. Oh, you'd like to find the joy in the stuff. Oh, yeah. You're the same, you can't get enough. No, you're gonna have to face that you're addicted to love. You see the signs, but you can't breathe. You're learning at a different speed. Your heart beats in double time. Another kiss, and you'll be mine. A one-track mind, you can't be sane.
Red Alert and the National Lottery. Tonight we have some fantastic music, we've got some great games, all thought up by the very talented Mr. Terry Alderton.
Yeah.
Isn't that right, Terry?
Yeah, I did. I made them up all myself.
Yeah. And why did they ask you to think up the games, Terry?
Because they had to be simple.
All the streets have to do is to get themselves enough points to win themselves a holiday away. As well as that, we've got the Thunderball draw and the National Lottery draw. So in the next hour, somebody could become a millionaire. Last week I had a date with NSYNC. This week I've got them in the studio. how I get along with Bryan Adams. Off a cloud number nine. And then I'll be doing something with Mel C that I've never done before.
And we got two more streets, yes, going hammer and tongs this time to chance to win a holiday to Ibiza for not just one, not two, not three, not five people, but for the whole street! Yeah! And it's a bit of a seaside special today because we've got a battle of the holiday resorts. Yes, we've got Ingleway Avenue from Blackpool! Yeah! And you lot, you're up against the map from Hastings! Yeah! A seaside extravaganza. It's the South Coast versus the North Coast. Well, it's not. It's the North West, but North. It's sort of. How's the sofa, Lou?
It's lovely, Terry, and I'd like you to have a seat on it.
Oh, fantastic.
One day. Now I want to introduce you to a singer who has just made the most brilliant solo album and had tremendous success with it. She's about to receive, along with her fellow Spice Girls, a Lifetime Achievement Award. Who else could it be? Scream like mad for Mel C. So what is it with the blonde hair?
Well, it's something to do with LA. Whenever I come back, I go blonde.
Do you? Yeah. I think every girl has to go blonde at some time in their life, don't you? Yeah. Yes, I think it's terribly important.
Give it a try.
Doesn't matter what your age is, darling.
No.
And the album. Now, what inspired you with this new album? Because it's really great.
Well, really, it's something I've wanted to do for a long time. Mm. And all the Spice Girls, when we first got together, we were really open and honest about what we wanted in the future. And that was to go on and do things individually as well as stay together as a band. Mm. And so it's just the album I've always wanted to make as a solo artist.
Yeah. And you feel a sense of achievement, yeah?
Yeah, definitely. It's a lot more personal when, you know, you're by yourself. And, of course, there's a lot more of my influences in the album. Mm-hmm.
Now, you must have met so many stars, so many famous people. Have any of them made you go weak at the knees?
Well, actually...
Yes. I won't tell anybody.
OK.
Right, just between you and me.
It's somebody who you've been singing with.
Me?
Yeah. Bryan Adams.
Bryan Adams! Oh, I have to tell you, he's double dating you. I went out with him yesterday. Oh. Yeah, we had a date.
Kill him. No, working with Bryan was fantastic.
Yeah.
I was so flattered that he asked me.
Yeah.
You know, and now he's a good friend now.
Now, Mel, when you go to receive your Lifetime Achievement, we all want to know, are there going to be four Spices or five?
Well, that is a question on everybody's lips, isn't it?
It is.
And mine too.
And are you going to tell me?
Well, I don't know. You know, there's five people who have to make that decision, but I can just say, on my behalf, I think Jerry should be there and I'd like her to be there.
Yes, we will all be watching and we'll be waiting with bated breath. Mm. How about it for Mel C?
Yes, it's a seaside battle. It's like the mods versus the rockers. Except it's not. So let's first meet our team all the way from Ingleway Avenue in Blackpool.
It's bold. It's brassy, and it's big on its tower. Hey, by gum, it's Blackpool! No, it hasn't gone to the dogs, but it is home to Ingleway Avenue, the street that lives, laughs and plays together.
Hi, I'm Gail. I'm Ingleway Avenue's team captain, because what I say goes around here. And I say that Barry Manilow is God. I'm his biggest fan. I'm also fanatical about these clowns. So much so, I even married one.
I'm Martina, and I've been picked for the team because I'm considered to be the street's babe. I keep myself fit by working out at least four times a week. And this is my party piece of the moment.
And I'm Debbie, and I had to be on the team because not only do the three of us live on the same street, but we also work in the same office. At home, I'm known as Hyacinth Bouquet. Things should be put in their proper place.
Hello, I'm Gail. I'm the leader of the street. I'm the team captain. You're busy, aren't you? You like Barry Manilow, then?
Yes, I do, yeah.
How much do you like Barry?
Lots.
Are you obsessed by Barry?
Yes.
What, so you're a fan or stalker?
Just a fan.
Just a fan. Let's find out. Are you a fan in that do you go to the Albert Hall to watch him in front of 6,000 people, or do you watch him picking his eggs and milk up at his front door at 7 in the morning?
No, just as far as the concert.
Do you know who you're playing?
Yes.
Shall I tell you who you're playing?
Yes, please.
They're all the way from Hastings. Do you know what the name of the road is? It's the Mount.
The Mount.
In Hastings. Yes. Let's go and meet them. Yeah.
Perched on the south coast, overlooking the channel, is the Mount, a des res where the neighbours are matey, the parties make the headlines, and they call the fish and chips scampi.
Hi, I'm Kerry, and I'm the Mount's team captain because I've lived here for 8 years. I love animals. In fact, my ambition is to open a poodle parlour on the side of my house.
I'm Lynn, and I've lived on the Mount with my husband Mark for 18 years. We're pretty house proud. Indeed, this very room was transformed on the TV series Changing Rooms, although I'm not sure about Lawrence's murals. I have been chosen to be on the team because some people say I look like Bette Davis.
And I'm Bill, and my ambition is to drive a Formula One car. In reality, though, I'm an estate agent who's pretty handy with a golf club. I've been picked for the team because I love this street more than anybody else.
You're a hairdresser.
Yeah.
But I did find out that you actually wanted to do pooches and stuff, dogs and whatever. You wanted to groom them, didn't you?
Yeah.
They said you became a hairdresser. So I saw you doing your dog there. Very nice. And all the washing him and the lovely hairstyles.
Yeah.
Have you ever worked on anyone's hair in the street? Have anyone else's hair on the street? Hi, Lynn.
Hi, Terry.
How are you?
All right, thank you.
That's a funky hairstyle, isn't it?
You think so?
You've got more hair than I have. I was actually thinking about having extensions on mine.
Yeah?
What do you think? What do you think? Do you want that to work, Kerry?
Dreadlocks, maybe.
Dreadlocks?
Dreadlocks.
They've got a lot good with dreadlocks, innit? Yeah, man. They've got bad with dreadlocks, innit? You know what I mean? So are you excited? Are you ready to play?
Yeah.
Do you think you're going to win?
Oh, yeah. Definitely.
Do you think you're going to win?
Oh, definitely.
Well, let's find out as we play the first game. Door to door. Yes, both streets are going to ask each other questions. It's 2 points for a correct answer. So, Gail, I'm coming over to you first and your team. So, Gail, who's going to ask your first question, please?
Tonight, Terry, I'm going to nominate my friend and neighbour, Linda, because we both share a love of music.
OK, Linda, what is your question, please, for the Mount?
Hi, I'm Linda, and I love Cliff Richard. I would like to know what song he sang in the 1968 Eurovision Song Contest.
I don't know. I've had many times. Do you think it was?
Congratulations.
What song?
Congratulations.
I want the world to know how happy I can be. Congratulations. And so, Kerry, who's your question coming from?
I've chosen Hayley.
Yeah.
As she's a fellow hairdresser who lives on the street.
OK, Hayley, who lives on the street, fellow hairdresser, what is your question, please, for Ingleway Avenue?
Hi, I'm Hayley, and I teach at the local Hair and Beauty College. My question is, who played the male lead role in the 1975 film Shampoo?
So, who played the male lead role in 1975 Shampoo film?
Warren Beatty.
Warren Beatty, that's 2 points. Martina, who's your question coming from, please?
My question's coming from Adrian, who I'm in competition with at the moment as being the street's biggest party animal.
Oh, Adrian, what could your question be for the Mount, please?
Hi, my name's Adrian, but I'm also known as Zoe.
I'm currently learning Spanish during my A-level next year, so name me one of the Balearic Islands. Hasta luego.
Oh, God, slightly Lily Savage. Name one of the Balearic Islands.
Mallorca.
Name one of them.
Mallorca.
Mallorca. Mallorca. Very good. That's 2 points. Bill, who's your question coming from, please?
I've chosen my neighbour Mel because she's got an unusual specialist subject.
OK, Mel, what's your subject, please, for Ingleway Avenue?
Hi, I'm Mel. I'm a seaweed specialist, and I do love to live beside the seaside. So my question is, which is the longest pier in Britain?
Where do you think the longest pier in Britain is?
Brighton.
Southend.
I've got to take Brighton, unfortunately. You didn't get the points. The second answer would have been right, would have been Southend.
Right.
But you didn't get the 2 points.
Sorry.
It's all right, but you like it. Well, I'll tell you something about Southend, shall I?
What?
I'm a Southend fan.
Ah.
Yeah, look.
Good.
Yeah, but is your nickname Buzzard?
Yeah.
Is that because you kill rabbits or something?
No, I don't.
So, Debbie, who's your question coming from, please?
Right. I nominate my other half, Colin, because I have to put up with his hobby.
OK, Colin, what's your hobby? Please ask us a question to the mount.
Hello, I'm Colin. I'm mad about motors. Who said that they could have a car in any colour they wanted as long as it's black?
Who said that a customer can have any car they want in any colour as long as it's black?
Henry Ford.
It was Henry Ford. That's another 2 points.
Yeah!
Well done. Well done. Lynn, who's your question coming from, please?
I've chosen to ask Debbie because, like me, she likes dressing up.
OK. Debbie, what's your question for Inglewaite Avenue, please?
Yeehaw! Howdy, partners. My name's Debbie and I'm a country and western fan. When I got married in this outfit. And my question to you is, which country and western star wrote Whitney Houston's hit, I Will Always Love You?
I'm not sure, but I'm going to say Garth Brooks.
Garth Brooks? Didn't he play football for Tottenham once? That was Dolly Parton. And at the end of that, you're just behind there on 2 points Ingle away, but in the lead, just slightly on 6 points, it is the Mount from Hastings.
Oh, question, answer, question, answer, question, answer. Oh, for some hot-blooded physical force.
In the next round of the Battle of the Streets, these two come face-to-face.
I'm Chandler the Chippy, the man on the mount. And I'm going to wring the ying out of your boy from Ingleway, haven't you?
I'm Ashworth the Arm Wrestler, Blackpool's Tower of Strength, and I'll saw you down to size, Chippy Man.
And you may come face to face with the winning numbers tonight with the Thunderball and the National Lottery draws. And Lulu has a date with everyone's favourite Canadian. Hey, it's Bryan Adams.
Well, now it's time for Mel C and her new single, Never Be the Same Again. I predict this is going to be huge. So let's hear it from Mel C.
About you and me.
the same again.
She's good now, Susie. Yes, she can't really think she's great.
When I was young... When I was young, right, we used to have disputes in the street and the children used to argue amongst each other, right? Yes. We used to sort it out. Do you know what we used to do?
What did we do?
Punch each other, right, and pull each other's hair.
But you're bald.
Yeah, but I used to lose a lot of fights.
But what's your point, Terry?
Arm wrestling.
Hailing from Hastings, it's Paul the Chippy Chandler. He's a carpenter as hard as nails and as thick as a plank. He's not. It could be a sore evening for Ingleway Avenue if this hard man has his way.
Be afraid. Be very afraid. I'll take the shirt right off your back.
Bowling in from Blackpool and the rock they're depending on, it's Tim Ashworth from Ingleway Avenue. So watch out the mount. He's capable of giving any opponent a run for their money.
I'm going to pin you down and plaster you all over the place.
It's worth 3 points for the strongest arm on the street. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to Woololand. Let's get ready to rumble! Fighting out of the tannery corner, Ingleway Avenue, Blackpool, terrible Tim Ashworth! And defending those 3 points all the way from the Mount in Hastings, would you please welcome Paul the Ferret Chancellor!
Okay, fellas, let's get your elbows on these pads. I want to see your hands on the pegs. Take your grips, guys. Take your grips. Hands over the centre of the table. Take your grips. Shoulder square. Bring this one in for me a little bit. Let's see these wrists straight. Straighten it up for me a little bit this side. Come on, Ferret, dig in. Stay there. Stay there. Be ready. Do not move. Ready, go! Keep pulling. Driving back. Keep that pressure backwards. Press your backwards all the time. Press your backwards. Eyes on your hands. Keep pulling. Keep pulling. Freedom! Yes, well, there we are. The 3 points going all the way to the Mount in Hastings. So, just behind still Ingleway Avenue from Blackpool, but from Hastings, the Mount, you're just in the lead with 9 points.
Yeah! Oh, well done. Will you shake hands, boys? Well done. Nobody's lost yet. So, there's plenty more points to grab in the next round if your teams can just keep their eyes peeled and answer questions about this next little piece of film.
He's back. Canada's 55 million record-selling artist Bryan Adams is set to move the masses with his latest offering, Don't Give Up, a collaboration with dance outfit Chicane. Well, I chatted with Bryan and Chicane's producer, Nick, over coffee and croissant down in Chelsea.
How did you two actually get together?
I rang up his record company and spoke to his mum because I'd heard a record that he did in Ibiza and I really liked his track. There wasn't a lot of lyrical content. It's more... tracks.
Okay, boys, you know, I'm a real romantic. Would you consider yourself romantic?
Kind of.
Totally romantic.
Oh, Ryan! So you're both romantics. Why do you live in London rather than in Canada or in New York?
I feel very comfortable here, and it's a good musical scene here. The fact that we live in sort of close proximity to each other.
Yeah.
Makes it simple just to get together in an afternoon and just put something together.
What's Don't Give It Up all about?
It's about staying optimistic about things.
Optimist. Would you say you were an optimist?
Sure.
Yeah, I'm quite looking forward to the rest of my day, actually.
Don't give up, don't have to, got
You've done lots of duets. Tina Turner, Barbara Streisand, Mel C, who I'm actually, I just work with.
Right.
And you're going to do one with me soon. We're going to do Cloud number 9. I love that track, actually.
Thanks.
Yeah, I really do like it. Well, it's a long way up, but it won't come down tonight. Well, it may be wrong, but baby, it sure feels right, all right. And the moon is up and the stars are bright, and whatever comes gonna be all right, 'cause tonight you...
And now we test your skills of observation.
Name one of the two cities on the shop front. Lynn?
Paris.
That's right, 2 points. What colour? What colour were the flowers on the table in the cafe? Martina?
Red.
They were red, 2 points. Yeah. How many pastries? How many pastries were there in the basket on the table? Kerry?
Four.
Four, correct, 2 points. Who did Brian speak to when he rang Nick's record company?
His mother.
His mother, right, 2 points. Yeah. Lulu and Brian talked about three people he's done duets with. Name two of them.
Mel C and Tina Turner.
That's right, 2 points. Name the song Brian has recorded with Chicane. Gail.
Don't give up.
Yes, it is, 2 points. What was the soup of the day in the cafe? Kerry.
Tomato and basil.
Correct, 2 points. And at the end of that, unfortunately, they've nipped you. It's 17 points to them out. You're going through to the final game and the chance to win that holiday.
Ah, you didn't win. Thanks for coming along. But you had a good day.
And
what a fabulous looking street Ingleway Avenue is.
Yeah!
And just think, if you wouldn't have come along, you wouldn't have met Terry.
Oh, that's
boy bands are very fashionable today, and I'm very happy about that because I think they're all cute.
I used to be in a boy band.
No, you didn't. This next band, I saw them performing live in America. They are fantastic. Let's hear it for NSYNC.
Start a fight. I know this can't.
British. You've got become very British as I last week. That was fabulous.
Oh, thank you.
Oh, yeah! It was so great. Anyway, you had a good trip. You've been around Europe.
We've been here for almost 2 weeks now.
Yeah.
Doing all of Europe, Germany, Spain.
Well, when are we going to see you touring here in this country? I want to come to a concert.
Oh. Hopefully late this summer, early fall.
Fantastic. So we'll all have to come and see you.
Of course.
I'm looking forward to that. Now tell me, how did you get your name? Let everybody know.
Justin's mom actually thought of the name.
Her mom?
It was, it's probably about 4 or 5 years ago. We were just sitting around throwing names out. And actually, at the time, Lance wasn't in the group. A kid named Jason was in the group. So she took the last letters of our first names and made NSYNC.
Your mother's very smart.
When he quit, Lance joined, and we started calling him Lanston.
Last week you started calling him Lanston?
Lanston.
It didn't stick.
No, darling, it doesn't suit you at all. Anyway, thank you so much for coming on the show. So great to meet you. And all the girls are very envious of me. NSYNC. Music to grow rich with. Well, in a few moments, we've got the Thunderball draw and the National Lottery draw. But right now, let's have a look and see what the Mount are playing for tonight.
Yes, the Mount. You could be jetting off to the beautiful Balearic island of Ibiza. Kick back and relax on the sandy white beaches, have fun in the water, and explore the island's charm. Viva Ibiza!
Okay, the Mount, it's down to you. All you've got to do to get that holiday. I'm going to ask you 5 questions. You answer 3 of the questions right, you win the holiday. Simple as that. I'll ask you a question. If you think you know the answer, then push the button that is in front of you. The computer will automatically select the first person to push the button, and then it's your responsibility for the whole street to answer that question, okay? So basically, get 3 of the 5 questions right, and you win that holiday. It's as simple as that, and there's no conferring. Thank you very much. Which 80s band took their name from the character in the film Barbarella? Okay, I can tell you 5 of you think you know the answer. Only 1 of you can answer. The person taking that responsibility for you is Steve Ferguson. Okay, Steve, you feel all right?
Yep.
It's only the first one. Which 80s band took their name from the character in the film Barbarella?
It's Duran Duran.
That's number 1. Okay, that's 1 down, 2 to go, and 4 questions to ask. So, here we go. Apart from Paris, what is the world's largest French-speaking city? Now, only 2 of you think you know this answer. And the person answering the question is Peggy.
Quebec.
Quebec? It's not right, I'm afraid. It's actually Montreal.
Close.
Doesn't matter. 3 more questions, and you've got to get 2, OK? Are you ready? It's like Christmas, isn't it? What does the U in a U certificate film stand for? Right, 8 of you have been brave this time. Who's going to take the responsibility for the Mount? It's John. All right, John?
Yeah.
You think you know it, John?
Yeah, I know it.
OK. I know it. I hope you do. They're all sitting again.
You're better.
What does the U in a U certificate film stand for?
Universal.
That's right, there's 2. Yeah. Come on! You've got to get 1 more, OK? 1 more and you're going. You're in the airport lounge now. Here we go. What did Alfred Nobel, the founder of the Nobel Peace Prize, invent in 1866? 6 of you think you know this, but only 1 person can take responsibility, and it's Steve Ferguson again. Steve, do you think you know it?
Dynamite.
Bang!
Yeah!
Oh, fantastic, on the sofa.
No, still. Well, now it's time for the Thunderball draw with Terence. Go on, dear.
That's right. It's Stand Up All Time again, and draw master John Willen, will you do what you do so well and release those balls, please? Splendid. Alan.
Terry.
Tell us what happened on last week's draw, please. Thank
you. Last week we had just one lucky punter who won the £250,000 Thunderball jackpot. 12 runners-up won £5,000 each. That's for matching five without the Thunderball. And 133 of you last week won £250 for matching four with the Thunderball in this game where the chances of winning a prize are greater. OK, Terry, the ball's up to speed.
Thank you, Alan. Thank you very much. Our official adjudicator is Phil Sayers. All right, Phil?
Sorry.
Lovely. OK, well, good luck, you lot, and here we go.
Don't forget to be in with a chance of winning a prize. You want one number or more from this first machine. Here is the first number. Number 11. Next. Up she comes. Number 30. The third one to be drawn. Number 3. Let's have another. 21. And the fifth one is about to appear. There it is. 26. OK, we have our first five balls. John, do the business, if you would. Start up the next machine and then release the Thunderballs. There they go. Terry.
Thank you very, very much, Alan. Yes, now to push this all-important Thunderball button, who better than our strongman, the big tough guy himself, Paul from the Mount. Hello, Paul.
All right.
You all right?
Well very done good. For that. Very good.
Right. Do the business then, Paul, and push the Thunderball button, if you would, please. Thank you.
To everyone I know and everyone I don't, the very best of luck.
If you already have our first five, this next number could make you £250,000 richer. Up she comes! 12! OK. This weekend's Thunderball numbers again, then, in ascending order for you. Check them off. They are 3. Yay! 11. Yay! 21. Yay! 26. Yay! And 30. Yay! The Thunderball this weekend is number 12. Terry.
Thank you very much, Alan. Thank you. Still to come, it's the big money draw when someone could be walking away with tonight's estimated jackpot. £7.2 million! £7.2 million! See, none. But it's all still to come, because you couldn't buy this, what I'm going to show you now, with all that money. You couldn't do it. You couldn't do it in a million years, because we have got Mel C and Lulu singing Drive My Car.
With Terry.
about 8 o'clock on Saturday, the 26th of February, and it's a national lottery draw here on BBC One and Radio 5 Live. So, Drawmaster John, do what you do so well. Do the honours for me. Thank you so much.
Midweek, there were two jackpot-winning tickets. The holders each receive just over £2 million. Good luck to you tonight. It's all down to Merlin and Setterballs number two, chosen earlier today by Harry Black from Bridport. Terry.
Thank you, Ellen. Right, tonight there is an estimated jackpot... Sorry, the estimated prize fund of £23 million. I'll get that right 1 week. And a jackpot estimated at £7.2 million. And to press that all-important button, would we please welcome our winning Captain Kerry from the Mount. All right.
Yeah.
You're going to go on that lovely holiday, aren't you?
I am.
But before you go, will you push that and make someone very, very happy?
OK.
Terry.
Okay.
Go, push it, push it.
Good luck, everybody. Yeah?
That's it. Right on.
We're off and running with tonight's National Lottery Draw live. And the first number is 45. Well, we've waited the longest to see again. 21 Wednesday, 68th lottery appearance. Next is number 8. Joined us the 13 Saturdays, back 54th time now as the main lottery ball. Third to be drawn tonight is number 6. Fourth draw in 3 weeks then for number 6, 45th time as the main lottery number. Next, 5. First out last weekend, you'll recall 70th time it's been drawn in the National Lottery. And the fifth one, number 3. Fifth number drawn 3 Wednesdays back in Manchester, 65th lottery appearance for that one. Interesting numbers. Next. Number 16. Also left out the Wednesday before last in Manchester. 45th time as a main ball. Now we need a bonus, and tonight's is 1! Now on red alert, tonight's winning numbers again, this time in ascending order. 3. 5. 6. 8. 16. And 45. The bonus is number 1. That's it. I hope some of those numbers were yours. Full details of tonight's draw in a National Lottery update after Casualty here on BBC One. Now time for us to go back to the lovely Lulu.
Terry. Come on, Terry. Who have we got on the show next week?
Next week we've got a real humdinger. We've got a street jetting in from Birmingham, and we've got a pony and trap coming all the way up from Dorset.
Aha! We've got the very successful, the very young Bewitched, and because Brian Adams took me out this week, I've invited him on the show next week.
Lovely.
We will see you there.
We will do.
A weekend of love in Sunburn at 5 to 9. Hearts are a little more fragile before that on BBC One. Casualties next.
If revising for your GCSEs seems too much to take in, why not break it down into more manageable chunks? With help from television, books and the internet, GCSE Bite Size can make your revision easier to digest. For your free GCSE Bite Size revision guide, call 08456 101522.
Dirty work.
He's a private detective. Devious is his middle name. His other middle name is Claude, but he doesn't like me to mention that.
Delicate work.
If you barge in when I'm handing over the cash, your carp will be sushi!
Risky work.
They think it's attempted murder. They'll try harder.
Dirty work.
You think you're hard, Beckett, don't you?
I'll show you hard.
Someone's got to do it. Dirty work. New drama coming in March to BBC One.
It's a case of sun-kissed rather than star-crossed lovers in Sunburn on BBC One in 50 minutes.